Muy buenas gente, aquí Tipper al habla, estamos de nuevo en un vídeo, en una nueva serie, estamos con Max Payne 3, un juego al que tenía muchísimas ganas de tener por aquí, por dos simples razones. La primera porque me encanta la saga y es la que me vio nacer aquí en YouTube, esta saga. Primer vídeo de mi canal es de Max Payne 1, es esa serie. Que por cierto, da un poco de cosica escucharme en esa serie, por Dios. Lo tenéis en la descripción, el Max Payne 1 y el 2. Y nada, este Max Payne nunca lo he jugado, esa es la segunda razón. Sí que es verdad que lo tengo en la plataforma que lo voy a jugar, que va a ser aquí en PC. Y también lo tengo en PlayStation 3. Pero bueno, este se ve mejor, obviamente. Y he querido que sea este el que venga aquí. Juego de Rockstar. Como no, todo el mundo conocemos a esta gran desarrolladora y no se puede decir mucho nada más que maravilla sobre ella, todo lo que toca es oro. Y bueno, pues juego de 2012, tiene su tiempecito, pero se ve increíblemente bien. Lo poquito que he podido jugarlo, lo he probado nada, así por encima un poco. Los controles son muy similares a los primeros, pero mejorados por mil y visualmente se ve muy bien. Pues gente, no os canso mucho más porque digo, me voy a ponerme a hacer aquí un discurso y no es lo que quiero tampoco, porque todo para mí sobre estas sagas son alabanzas. En esta historia de Max Payne 3, si no me equivoco, pasamos por lo que fuimos, que fue agente de la DEA, policía de Nueva York, y ahora somos como un guardaespaldas en la ciudad de Sao Paulo, Brasil. Para una familia adinerada, si no me equivoco. Y nada, pues vamos a darle a esta historia. Cierto es que lo voy a jugar con teclado y ratón. Los Max Payne, los primeros, me encantaba jugarlos con teclado y ratón. Fue cuando empecé yo a tocar más o menos PC. Sí, cuando tuve mi primer PC, es cuando jugué los dos Max Payne. Y creo que, aunque me cueste, porque obviamente no soy jugador así muy asiduo de PC, pues nada. Me tendré que acostumbrar. Vamos a hacerlo en dificultad media. No quiero tampoco sufrir de más. Para que sea mucho mejor para todos. Lo mismo para verlo que para mí jugarlo. No lo vamos a hacer en fácil, pero sí en medio. Y nada, me callo.
This place is great. Really comfortable. Just gonna get settled in. Time to move on. Get on with my life. Yes, absolutely. Said it was a long time ago. Let it go, seriously.
Los pelos de punta. Hemos dado un Max mucho más demacrado, pero Dios, la melodía, uff, de 10.
Definitely more my style than Panama or Hoboken, I guess. No, if I'm honest, I just got kind of bored of boozing. I mean, once in a while, but not all the time. You're right, it wasn't doing me any favors. Maybe I'd lost my self-respect, but it's back. I'm excited, really. I really needed a new start. I think you're right. I think I am gonna like it here. It certainly ain't New Jersey. It's my new life. Just like you said. Listen, if you think I can still do a job, what have I got to lose? Apart from the weight. Very funny, ha ha. Yes, that is a fake laugh, you jerk. So I guess I'd become what they wanted me to be. A killer. Some rent-a-clown with a gun who puts holes in other bad guys. Well, that's what they had paid for, so in the end, that's what they got. Say what you want about Americans, but we understand capitalism. You buy yourself a product and you get what you pay for. And these chumps had paid for some angry gringo without the sensibilities to know right from wrong. Here I was, about to execute this poor bastard like some dime store angel of death. And I realized they were correct. I wouldn't know right from wrong if one of them was helping the poor and the other was banging my sister.
Capítulo 1.
I'd arrived in Sao Paulo a few weeks before. I was working a protection detail for the kind of people who need protection in a town like this. And what kind of town was this? One where I didn't speak the language and they didn't water down their drinks. So for now, we seemed to get along just fine. Of course, that was about to change.
Hey, brother.
Hey.
How's the cocktail?
Scotch. I never mix my drinks.
Well, at least not on duty.
Something like that.
Man, that favela is big.
Yep. Nothing like the view of extreme poverty to make a penthouse cocktail party really swing.
I guess they call it trickle-down economics.
That's funny.
It's supposed to be a charity thing. Drink and give money. I don't know, something for the kids. Hey, listen, man. We better look lively. This place is a nightmare. Just got cowboys running security downstairs. Something rotten in the air.
That didn't mean much. There was always something rotten in the air. The family we were protecting were local celebrities, rich parasites with delusions of humanity. The kind of people who end up in glossy magazines or body bags, depending on how their luck runs.
So where are they all? I see Rodrigo over there talking to that guy.
Yeah, I don't know him. That guy next to him. He's some kind of cop. I'm not sure. Serious, though. Big end cop, anti-gang sort of thing. I can't remember his name.
So who's this guy?
That guy's a plastic surgeon or some kind of surgeon. Tummy tucks and cock implants. Ha! Look at Marcel. Still dances like a fool.
Guess that's what a European education and a coke habit will do for Ricky Martin look-alike.
That's very funny, Max. Oh, excuse me.
I was mostly working for Rodrigo Branco, a local businessman. Built things, did some charity, had things named after him, won awards, owned things, people. One of the trophies he had won was his wife, Fabiana. She was hot and wanted to be dangerous. Some good genes trying to fight their way out of a cesspit. She'd married well and was now at leisure to regret her good fortune. They got along as well as any rich workaholic and his younger airhead wife tend to get along. They mostly ignored each other. She spent a lot of time with his cokehead younger brother, Marcello. He was a good time guy if your idea of a good time was an expensive suit, a bottle of champagne, and nothing between the ears. The middle brother, Victor, had just walked in. He was a local politician. Guy was smoother than an oil slick on an iceberg and about as toxic. The rest of the crowd, I didn't know, but I could imagine the types. People who know if they drink enough, they won't have to feel guilty about their good fortune. Suddenly, things turned real ugly. Felt like our hangovers arrived right on cue.
Problemas. Era como bastante obvio, ¿no? Familia muy adinerada delante de las favelas.
Things had gone from fine to fucked up in about a second, and now there were two idiots at the wheel.
Clear. You got this floor?
Sure.
Look after yourself, bro. Stay safe.
It wasn't my own safety I was concerned about, trophy wife or not. I'd said I would protect the girl.
Hey. Vale. ¿Cómo me ponía cubierto? No recuerdo cómo me ponía cubierto, gente. Pues menuda maravilla. Me gusta muchísimo cómo se ve. Es brutal. Aquí, si no me equivoco, había un arma oculta. Pero esto, al tener que ver con Rockstar, está la partida se guardó en la nube, lo que probé. Y no he tenido la manera de resetear todo. ¡Toma ya! Tengo que hacerme, como digo, los controles. A ver, ¿qué tenemos por ahí? Vale, tiempo, bala. Es lo que más... No puede... Las balas las pilla él solo, vale, bien. Lo que más caracteriza a esta saga. El bullet time. Vamos a usarlo ahora. Por aquí, por ejemplo. O igual no, porque me lo he encontrado de golpe.
Cinco balitas. That was the boss lady. Only this time she wasn't calling for more vodka in her Cosmo. I didn't need a translator to know what these were.
Analgésicos, muy míticos. Vale. Yo creo que son pistas.
And I hoped not about to be thrown off it.
A ver, ¿por aquí hay algo? Porque se sale por ahí. O sea, es por ahí por donde tengo que ir. Echar un vistazo. No parece. Así que vámonos. Creo que hay botón de sprint.
Sooner or later I'd have to go out there and see what was happening.
Problemas, vamos. Fabiana, ¿no? Sí.
It might have been stupidity, or drunkenness, or maybe both. But before I knew it, I was back taking insane risks, trying to save fallen women.
Buah, qué guapo.
Tranquila, tranquila. Nos cuidamos disso.
Nice work. Hey, you need a hand?
No, you. Where the hell's Rodrigo?
I don't know, man. Thanks.
Somebody's gotta go find him.
Toma mi arma que está mojada.
Fica tranquilo.
No sé por qué no está totalmente traducido. Cuando hablan en brasileño, bueno, portugués.
The elevator door is opening to a firing squad of muzzles. As far as I could see it, the one thing my plan had going was that no one else would be stupid enough to pull this move.
Where you got?
Vale. Nadie. Me encanta muy, o sea, es que me está gustando muchísimo el tiempo bala que tiene. O sea, el saltar así, poder disparar lo que quieras y aparte quedarse en el suelo. Porque así no pierdes el tiempo mientras se levanta. Entonces cuando ya lo tengas todo despejado, entonces te levantas. Está muy bien. Es como digo, a mí me encantaban los primeros y su manejo. Y este lo tiene muy mejorado. No recuerdo. Vale. Me han hecho pupita, ¿eh? Analgésicos para adentro. ¡Buah! ¡Qué guapo!
Dragging Bronco along would slow them down, but not much.
Esto es para mí, sí señor. ¿No tienen más cartuchitos por ahí? A ver si hay alguna cosita que se pueda hacer. ¡Eh! Armas doradas, no sé para qué sirven. Supongo que son coleccionables. Para, bueno, pues lucir con un arma todo bonita. Pero ya está. Registraré más o menos todo lo que pueda, pero pues eso. Sí que es cierto, el último enemigo que se encuentra en la sala va a morir a cámara lenta. ¿Qué llevas? Pues una escopeta automática. Muy bien.
It looked like they were taking him out through the basement. Maybe I still had a shot. I had to move quick, or Bronco's next charitable donation Rodrigo would be to the worms. Rodrigo was too rich a prize for them to throw away. Sure, I'd have to work hard to get him back, but I knew the bad guys would have the boss alive. Almost as much as I did.
Vale. ¿Cómo puedo cambiar el arma?
They weren't far ahead. Once I opened the door, I'd actually have to come up with a plan.
Vamos a tomar analgésicos. No sé, ¿cómo cambio el arma secundaria? 9. A ver, el 1. No, el 9 la suelta. O sea, yo cambiaba con la rueda del ratón, así. Dejar el arma, me pone. Entonces, si hago así, la cambia, ¿no? Vale, simplemente hay que darse prisa. Correcto. Buena munición. ¿Tenemos por ahí o qué? No me extrañaría nada que hubiese alguna pieza o algo. Parece que no. Vale. A la Q nos cubrimos. Es que quiero eso, como digo, hacerme un poquito a los controles. Porque si no vamos a pillar de lo lindo ahora es fácil, pero más adelante.
Once Bronco was out the door, all bets were off. The great thing about being famous as well as rich is the bad guys know who to kidnap. Another parking lot rattling.
La verdad que para
was I too late?
Para tener los años que tiene, luce muy bien, ¿eh? Se ve muy bien. ¿Cómo que reintentar? Ah, que tengo que darme prisa. Qué bien, ¿eh? ¡Bum! ¡Se lo llevan!
¡Rodrigo!
Brutal.
Mr. Bronco.
Que no me has pagado el mes todavía. No.
You're okay. You're okay. Yeah. Come on, get up.
Quedan increíbles estas escenas.
Come with me. Just come. It's okay. Just stay right
here. Ei, vocês aí! Que porra vocês estão fazendo? A justiça local?
Que porra você acha que é falando com meus homens assim?
Você acha que tem o direito de matar as pessoas a sangue frio, Becker?
Cala a boca, cuzão! Continua dando multas. Não põe o nariz onde não é chamado. Vamos!
Chama uma ambulância!
Me ajuda.
Fuck.
You did good, Max.
You say so. Don't look so good.
Hey, what could be better, huh? The good guys are reunited and the Commando Sombra are dead.
I guess.
Commando Sombra.
So who's this guy?
I don't know. Some kind of cop. Different branch of the police. Not UFE, but normal cops. I don't know about this stuff, politics. Everywhere politics. Shit, Max, you look kind of beat up. Let's get this lot home and then I'll get you home too. Come on.
Back home, it was time for some R&R, the only way I knew how.
Oof. No ha cambiado, Max.
That, I guess I was ready for bed.
Capítulo 2. Dirás casi lo mejor. Martes siguiente.
A couple of days later, it was back to work. Ferrying the boss's broad and his dipshit of a brother out for the night so they could recover from their brush with mortality. Then again, what did I expect? These were the kind of people who went to nightclubs in helicopters. Fabiana had brought her sister along, presumably so she could show off just how rich and empty her life was. And boy, was she about to learn the meaning of rich and empty.
Max! Max! I was speaking to you!
Sorry, what was that?
Oh, I was saying we get into a lot of scrapes, man.
Well, we're still here.
Hey.
Thanks to you, Max. I owe you my life.
Boom. It wasn't just him, huh, baby?
Oh, yes, Marcel. I'm sure you did a lot to save everyone. You were probably worried about getting blood on your stash.
Very funny.
Thank you, Max. I don't know what I would do without my sister.
Mmm. Spend even more time doing something useful. You know she works in the favela. She's the good sister.
Oh, shut up. What did you hear, Faba? More bodies turned up, more people went missing. It's horrifying.
Did someone say Buzzkill?
Hey.
I'm just kidding, but it is a cool town, man. Hey, here we are. Salud.
Sí, me da que la voy a necesitar. Con estos tres. A ver, el portugués no es complicado y se medio entiende, pero estaría bien que estuviera totalmente traducido.
Like a whore during Fleechy Week, as my roommate used to say. You like that, Max?
That's pretty funny.
De hecho, los otros Max Payne están doblados incluso. No sé cuántos problemas me dará esto con copyrights por Rockstar y por músicas. No lo sé. Ya veremos.
This kind of place made me want to puke. I needed a real drink to deal with the electronic music and the robotic people.
Fucking monkey from a fucking slum. He acts cool with me.
What's that?
Nothing. Say, Max, you're a man of the world. What are you fucking doing, man?
About what?
What do you do about life?
Look at me, I'm standing in a nightclub. Listening to music I can't stand. I'm 5,000 miles from home. I'm armed and I'm drinking. You don't want to listen to advice from me.
Oh, Max, I love you, man. You're fucking real, you know? Oh, shit. People. Fuck them. People get me wrong. I think I love a wrong woman. Oh, excuse me. Fabio! Fabio! Oh, ah, my nigga!
Qué buenos son los diálogos de este juego. Pero todo lo de Rockstar. It soon turned out I wasn't the only one. ¡Vamos! ¡Mega épico! he dado, sí. Qué grande.
I hadn't seen it coming, but that was no surprise. It's hard to keep your eye on the ball through the bottom of a glass. I just hoped I could get to Fabiana and Giovanna in time.
Vale, Fabiana. Tengo un revólver también. ¿Me lo puedo llevar o cambio el arma?
I knew if I didn't get to the girls soon, they'd be leaving this place with either a price on their heads or a tag on their toes.
Si me meto mucho analgésico, voy a fliparlo. No, no saltes así. No hay botón de salto normal. Me voy a aporrear contra zambullera lenta. Eso que es un logro. Pero bueno, ahora llevo un revólver y un arma. ¿Cómo cruzo? Es que ese es el problema. Voy a gastar el bullet time. Vale. A ver si hay algo por aquí. Aunque me da que si tardo mucho se va a ir todo a tomar viento. Vámonos.
Uf. I was lost. The last time I'd been in a nightclub, it was in a different century, and I'd left head first out of the back door with a foot up my ass. The girls were gone, and so was I.
Fallado. Hay que darse prisa, gente. Hay que darse prisa. No puedo pararme a buscar cositas. Y esto me había salido bien. Vale, pues lo pillo, juego. Lo pillo. ¿Quién queda? Además,
seen it coming, but that was no surprise. It's hard to keep your eye on the ball through the bottom of a glass. I just hoped I could get to Fabiana and Giovanna in time.
Una Uzi.
The doors had been chained shut. I didn't need my Portuguese for beginners phrase book to work out what was going on. The guy making the noise was the boss. He was sending them around to cut me off from the other side. And sure enough, a few seconds later, I had some company on the dance floor. There had to be another way out through the VIP lounge. Rich fools love a private exit.
Qué bueno.
Figured this time I'd use the stairs.
Vamos, necesito munición. Vale. Vamos. Genial. No sé por qué cambio una por otra, la verdad. Buah, está todo lleno, la gente herida.
Hey, Sao Paulo's famous bodyguard. How's it going, bro?
It's not good. Some guys took Giovanna and Fabiana.
What? Jesus, Max. Hey, I'm on my way.
No, no, no. Stay in the chopper. We'll need a way out of here. I'll go find the girls.
They came out of there. They went that way into the lounge.
Come here.
Go.
Get up. Get up. You can't stay here. I need you to lock this door behind me. Get everybody else out of here. Son of a bitch.
Es lo que digo. Las actuaciones de voz en los juegos de Rockstar son brutales. Mierda, le he metido un tiro a un camarero. Cojones. Sigue vivo. Además, vale, nivel este es brutal. Vamos, Es increíble. Vale.
Don't shoot, por favor.
You're an American?
Sure. Yeah, I'm from Steele, North Dakota, just outside of Bismarck. Anders Detling. This is some place, huh? They told me it was a little fresh, but I wasn't expecting things to be quite like this.
No?
No, see, I've seen things. I was a cop for 25 years. I've seen men run over by combines. I've seen husbands who just ate their wives, but a gunfight at a disco?
You were a cop?
Yeah, just retired. Oh, what a life that was. And it gave me the money to raise a family. Oh, I got a girl at college at Wisconsin and a boy who's playing football for Minnesota State. You want to see their picture?
No, no, that's all right. Sounds nice. Listen, you stay in here. Don't be a hero.
Oh, I won't. I'm retired.
Happy, healthy ex-cop? Give me a break.
Vale. Porque no hay nada interesante, ¿no?, que buscar. No parece. Buah, gente, ahora me están entrando unas ganas locas de jugar otras cosas de Rockstar.
Whatever the hell they were arguing about, it was time for me to add my two cents.
Voy a curarme. Que me pase un poco. Vale. Toma. Espero que los fuegos no estén encendidos. Ahí está. Bien. ¿El periódico?
Victor's political campaign was starting to come unstuck. Seemed the Broncos' luck was on the turn. If only that was the worst news they'd received that day.
Pistas. Periódico examinado. Es el hermano, Víctor Branco. El hermano de... para quien trabajamos. Pero bueno, en general, la familia Branco, adinerada, famosa. ¿Vale? Vamos allá.
They were still alive, at least. This crew was starting to look a lot like friends of the gatecrashers at last week's party. These guys had some real issues with the Broncos.
Uh-oh.
They were back to finish the job. I figured it was time to start doing mine.
Coño. La segunda arma que llevo, ¿cuál es? Pistola normal, ¿no? Vale, bien. Veo otro que hay. Ahí lo llevas. ¡Buah! Brutal. Bien. Armas doradas. No. Voy a tener copyright en todo. Todo. Me parece un poco exagerado.
This wasn't the time to be second-guessing myself. I had to hurry or I'd lose them.
Bien. Por aquí, ¿no? Espera, he visto analgésicos aquí. Venga.
I'd gone head first through a glass window. I deserved a little something for the pain. They were headed for the helicopter pad. I had to get to the roof before Giovanna and Fabiana left on a one-way flight. I knew this was going to be a bad idea, but in the continued absence of any good ones, I decided to go with it.
¿Qué son unos tejados para ti, Max? Estás acostumbrado.
I guess my time in Sao Paulo wasn't quite the paid holiday in the sun I'd been promised. At least I was getting shot at by a bit of class of psychopath. These guys weren't messing around. This place was like Baghdad with G-strings. A couple of more seconds and I'd have given some poor street cleaner a crappy start to his day. Now, I had a ride to catch.
Pull me up, Bob, pelo amor de Deus!
All I said!
Come on, come on! Jesus, Max, I can't leave you alone for 5 minutes! What the hell happened in there?
They jumped us! Same guys from the party, I think. They grabbed the girls and Marcelo, but he's here now.
Yeah, don't worry about me, homie. I'm just the guy paying you lots of money to protect me.
Yeah, what were you drinking?
Bet your ass I was. You try staying in there for 5 minutes sober.
Oi, olha!
Look, there they are!
Giovanna! Giovanna!
Come on,
quick, get after them! Are you crazy? We can't just leave her! Max, you gotta do something! Come on! Get the rifle back there!
¡Vamos! ¡Bájame! ¡Bájame! ¡Jodas! A ver, me ha dado tiempo solo un tiro. Vale. Bien, recarga. Voy a recargar ahora con el bullet time, tío, no me jodas. Venga, venga, venga. ¡Vamos! ¿No ha dado tiempo? Oh, hay que ser rápido con esto, ¿eh? Bueno, obviamente, cargarme primero al pavo aquel o al misil. Ah, es lo que quiere.
Army of these goons. Clearly, somebody wanted these girls bad. Or maybe they just assumed the Bronco security team consisted of more than a drunk American has-been and a Brazilian never-was who should have paid more attention in flying school. Either way, I needed to find Giovanna before they did.
Giovanna, Giovanna. Está por aquí. A ver. ¿Qué tenemos? Munición. Vamos con las dos. Preferiría una pistola automática. No puede ser el caso. Llevar dos UCIs, ¿qué tal? Esto debe de reventar. Ya las recuerdo yo en los otros Max. Vale. Vamos. ¿Muerto o qué? No se parece. Están muertos los dos, ¿no? Vale. Analgésicos para adentro. Entra. ¿Qué coño? ¿Es por aquí? Eso parece. No. Poniendo finísimo, ¿eh? La escopeta no es la mejor idea. Puta, qué pariu. No, píllate. Sus controles, tío. Dispara. ¿Por qué no disparo? 0 de 0. Genial. Genial. No tenía 20 cartuchos. Curaría. Estoy sin munición. ¡No, coño! ¡Ah! No he visto nada, tío. ¡Dejadme recargar! No me jodas, ¿desde aquí? Bien. Necesito analgésicos. ¡Oh! No había pasado por aquí antes. Sigue vivo. Ya no. Vale. Vamos. Escopeta, escopeta.
The odds on Giovanna still being alive were getting worse by the second. And if Fabiana wasn't dead already, I was guessing pretty soon she'd start wishing she was. I was up for one god-awful performance review.
Pues está, ella ha entrado por aquí, pero hace mucho rato ya. Y había mucha peña por medio.
This was a mess. Where the hell was Passos? We were two failed cops failing miserably at being bodyguards. He approached everything with about as little preparation as I did. Maybe that's why we got along.
Giovanna! Giovanna!
Max! Over here! What's happening? Where were you?
Are you all right?
What, do I look all right?
Don't worry, we're gonna get you out of here.
Passos, where is he? Is he okay?
You had to make a quick detour. He's fine. He's right there.
Oh my god. It's Kaul!
Giovanna!
No. A ver lo que.
Giovanna. Hey. No, nothing. Go.
Seems like I wasn't the only guy around here who had taken his eye off the ball.
Are you okay?
My weakness was the drink. Passos was the sister. Things were turning pretty ugly in this town. The boss's girl was gone, and part of me wished I was too.
Poof. Estaba muy encariñado nuestro compañero Passos con ella, con Giovanna. Vale, gente, pues hasta aquí el episodio de Max Payne 3. Espero que sea una serie que os mole, porque ya digo, yo tenía unas ganas locas de traerlo. Hago el corte este así un poco abrupto porque, obviamente, estáis viendo, el episodio ha sido bastante largo. Y bueno, aún seguía un trocito, pero eso ya lo añadiremos en el siguiente episodio, gente. Y pues nada, pues como siempre digo, gente, pues muchísimas gracias por haberlo visto. Espero que os haya gustado. Si dejáis un pequeño like, un comentario, lo agradezco mucho. Podéis dar dislike si no os ha gustado, que se le va a hacer. Suscribiros al canal siempre que os guste el contenido. Y nada, nos vemos, gente. Un saludo. Chao, chao.